All right, another example that we have of social media and how we exploit it, and this is actually really, really common, is we Facebook reviews. And we had a hospital, it wasn't Cleveland Clinic, but I'll use them as the example, that said, hey, we want you to try and get patient data or PII or PHI. And we're not going to tell you anything. You just got to go on the internet, use open source intelligence, and try and get data. And we actually learned this from breach response. A hacker actually did this to one of our clients. So we ended up doing it as part of this engagement. So what we do, and what a lot of hackers do, is they'll go on Facebook and look at the Facebook reviews. So if you own a company, you're part of a company that, you know, you have a lot of customers, you do a lot of business to consumer transactions, Facebook reviews are big. Because if I go on your Facebook page, I see someone reviewed it, I got a lot of information out, right? I know that in this case, Ken Flass reviewed Cleveland Clinic. He said he's been coming there since February of 2016. He sees Dr. Kayok, it's great. He's from Sharon, Pennsylvania. So just in this one review, he gave us a ton of information about him and really his relationship with Cleveland Clinic. What we then did is I went on Cleveland Clinic's page, found his doctor, Ralph Kayuk, and I also found his PA, Katie Cruz. And this is important because when we're going to try and get his data, we're gonna exploit the relationship between the PA and the doctor, and we'll get to that in a second. I then went on a website called Spokio. I think Spokio is free now, but it used to be like $5 a month. It's like white pages on steroids. So I looked up Ken Flask, found his phone numbers, found where he lived, found his address history, found his relatives. I could find everything about this guy. So now I knew when he was coming from Cleveland Clinic, I knew who he was seeing. I know where he lives. I know his phone numbers. I know his address history. I know his relatives. I know everything about this guy, except his social, pretty much. So at this point, I forged an email. So I pretended to be Dr. Kayok and I emailed Katie Cruz. And what I did is I used the domain of cleveland-clinic, not email, not clevelandclinic.com, because obviously I can't buy that because it's owned. I emailed Katie. I said, hey, you know, I'm out of the office. Ken Flass called. He needs a referral. Can you fax his medical records to this email or to this number? She sees the email, says, sure thing, doc, gets right on it. And the next thing you know, she faxes over medical records. And this whole thing, right, this whole attack took maybe 15 minutes. We tested 11 people, 9 of them sent us medical records. And they're all based off Facebook reviews. We just went on Facebook, looked at a review, took that person's name, found the doctor they were using if they used it in the review, and then exploited that. So if you're a proponent of leaving Facebook reviews, right, just know that when you do it, you're leaving a lot of data out there that hackers can use. If you have a business as a Facebook page where people can review it, I always recommend turning it off. I think there's a setting where you can turn it on, but they can't put any comments in it. So they can't tell you things like who they saw or leave a lot of information out there.